السلام عليكم.
We begin by praising Allah Azza wa Jal, Lord of the Alameen, which is mankind, jinn, and everything that exists. And we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his messenger. Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. O you who believe, fear Allah, the fear that He deserves, and die not except in a state of absolute submission to Allah, Islam. Do not die except in a state of absolute submission and utter obedience to Allah. That's what Islam is, my dear brothers, in Islam. In another verse, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. So we got Muslimun, and now we got Fasiqun. Who are the Muslimun, my dear brothers in Islam, and who are the Fasiqun? The Muslimun are the ones who submit to Allah Azza wa Jal in each and every single aspect Allah Azza wa Jal orders in Islam. Not a few of the rulings of Allah and the rest ala Allah. Every single thing Allah commanded us to do, we submit to it. And the fasiqun, my dear brothers in Islam, the ones who leave the obedience of Allah, who are damned on the Day of Judgment, and are the hopeless losers on the Day of Judgment, they're the ones who fall into the major sins and who are persistent and consistent in the minor sins. Allahu Akbar. It's not just the ones who fall into major sins that are damned and are of the losers on the Day of Judgment. It's also the ones who constantly commit the minor sins. My dear brothers in Islam, do I dare say we fall into this category? How many of us continuously fall into the minor sins, non-stop? And most of the time it's the same sin, again and again and again. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal, in these verses, in the first verse, He's basically telling you, don't you dare die other than in absolute submission to Me. What does this mean, my dear brothers in Islam? In one of the verses he explains, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أُدْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً. Allah Azza wa Jal emphasizes on this word 6 times. Just like in وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ, He emphasizes 6 times that these people are those who are astray. Here in this ayah, subhanallah, it's not a coincidence that this specific word had to be emphasized 6 times. So that He can tell you and explain to you and emphasize to you that you have to fall into complete submission, wholeheartedly, unequivocally, no hesitation, no objections, in each and every single aspect that Allah ordered us with. 6 times He emphasized. 6 harakat used met this word to show you the importance of not applying part of your deen, accepting it, and rejecting the other part. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. As for the one who doesn't enter into Islam completely, 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 completely 6 times, he is the one who follows the footsteps of the shaitan. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُّبِينٌ. Verily, he is to you a clear enemy. What does Allah Azza wa Jalla then say, my dear brothers in Islam? And this is a dangerous part. فَإِنْ زَلَلْتُمْ. As for you, O so-called Muslim, who backslides, falls back off My orders, rejects part of My deen. مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْكُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. After the clear signs have come to you, after you knew what Allah had ordered you and what He had forbidden you from doing, what's the recompense? فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allahu Akbar. Allah didn't say, I'm going to punish you. He didn't say there's hellfire for those. He gave you two of his sifat, two of his traits. And then know that Allah Azza wa Jal is the owner of a strong and unwavering retribution and with a swift and wise order. See, Shaykh Abdul Rahman Al-Sa'di, he says in his tafsir, verily in this verse is a stern warning. In this ayah is a stern warning. Why? It is a stern warning to follow Allah Azza wa Jal in absolutely all aspects of Islam, of his deen. Or else you take the risk of standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal and he tells you, I'm not your Lord. Your Lord was your own desire. How? How could this happen, my dear brothers in Islam? Imagine a person having prayed and fasted, attended the mosque, given sadaqah, raised his kids right. But on the day of judgment, when he comes to take his hasanat for these actions, Allah tells him, go and get the hasanat from your Lord. He says, Allah, what do you mean? I did this for you. He goes, no, you didn't. Didn't you choose to accept part of my deen and you rejected the other part? He says, yes. He says, why did you do that? And the answer is, my dear brothers, we only accepted the part that we did follow and accept and apply because it agreed with our desire. And we only rejected the part that we did reject because it agreed with our desire. So in reality, all we're following is our desire, not Allah. أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَاهُ. Have you seen, O Muhammad, the one who takes his Lord to be his desire? That's why, my dear brothers in Islam, you have brothers with a big beard, long abaya, at the mosque every single day, but he lies and cheats in every single dealing that he does. I'm not talking about the one who simply made a mistake. He slipped a lie here or there. He accidentally, left for darish way. No. I'm talking about the one who constantly lies and cheats, who believes in his heart that he has to lie and cheat to get his rizq. Not Allah Azza wa Jal is the provider. No iman in Allah, or no acknowledgement that Allah made this action haram. Are they only kuffar? When in the entire seerah did the Prophet ﷺ lie and cheat a kafir? Or do you pick and choose what you want from your deen as it pleases you? Or that sister that wears the hijab, wears the abaya, comes to the lessons, but every single gathering, she sits there, backbites and slanders. I'm not talking about the sister who slipped up, who said something she shouldn't have said, who repented or regretted. I'm talking about the sister who and the brother. The brothers these days, Allahu Akbar, even sometimes worse than the sisters. Every single gathering, did you see that bloke? Did you see what he did? Did you see what he wore? Did you see what he said? Did you see what he bought? And when you come and you advise these people, brother, this is haram. I can't help it. He's decided to completely reject a part of our deen. These are the ones who Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, or before that, and this is becoming common. The sister who gets divorced, and then she comes to the Shaykh and tells him, I don't want to do iddah. I don't want to do iddah. Allahu Akbar. Like, who said it's up to you? Since when are we allowed to pick and choose what we want from the deen? Or he doesn't deserve a adde, as if the adde is for him. The adde is for Allah Azza wa Jal. He's the one that ordered us to do it. Before it's a right of his. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says in the Quran a verse. And look at my dear brothers how he begins this verse. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ Subhanallah. It is not befitting for a believing man or a believing woman. Look how he started off the ayah. It's as if he's nullifying our iman. It is not befitting for a believing man or a believing woman. إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. That if Allah or His Prophet were to make an order for them to have a choice in the matter. It's not your choice. If you want to be a mu'min, a believer of Allah, if you want to be a Muslim, a submitter of Allah, you don't have a choice. If you want to have a choice, don't call yourself a Muslim. If you think you have a choice, don't call yourself a Muslim. Don't lie to yourself. Be ready to face Allah on the Day of Judgment. And He tells you, why did you reject part of my deen? Have your answer ready. Again, I'm not talking about the one who makes a mistake, the one who stuffs up, the one who commits a sin and then repents and does it again, and repents and does it again, and repents and does it again, he's still alright. I'm talking about the one who completely does not acknowledge that ruling in Islam. He doesn't want to have anything to do with it. My dear brothers, in Islam, we don't have a choice. If you want to die in a state of Islam, a state of absolute submission to Allah Azza wa Jal, you cannot have a choice in any of the matters. When someone tells you, brother, this is wrong, you have to immediately stop it. Not like that sister who once told, someone was telling me this story, he approached his sister and told her, the thing, this 1, 2, 3 that you're doing is haram. She told him, yeah, I know it's haram, but I still want to do it. Allahu Akbar. You know, if she said, I know it's haram, wallah, I'm trying to stop it, I keep stuffing up. Khair wa barakah. I know it's haram, but I still want to do it. أخذتهم العزة بالإثم. Her pride and arrogance took over, so she continued her sin in pride and arrogance. Or that brother and that sister who go to the doctors that are of the opposite gender. Where in Islam did Allah Azza wa Jalla allow that? Where in Islam does Allah give you the right to go and be touched or even take off your clothes in front of the opposite sex? Do you know how bad it's gotten? Do you know when you give an inch, a mile gets taken? The shaitan takes you a mile. Do you know how bad it's gotten? Now you've got female sisters who are going to male gynecologists. They're stripping down, opening their legs in front of a man. That's because they left their deen. They decided not to acknowledge a part of their deen. Absolute shamelessness. Nothing is left of their shame. If you are able to do that action. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, do you dare? أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. Do you actually dare take part of my religion and reject the other part? فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَى أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. And what is the recompense of the one who chooses to follow part of my religion and reject the other part, except for a humiliating disgrace in this world and in the hereafter, they're going to be consigned to the most grievous of punishments. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And do not ever think Allah Azza wa Jalla is unaware of what you're doing. Not what you've done, not what you're going to do in the future, right now what you're doing, don't think Allah is unaware. My dear brothers in Islam, if we want to be of the Muslims, we don't have a choice in the matter. And this country is a perfect place where you can test whether you're really a Muslim or a mu'min. Because in this country, there's more freedoms. You can pick and choose. It's more clear whether you're a Muslim or not. It's more clear whether you're a mu'min or not. It's more clear whether you're a Muslim or a fasiq. Because you can choose, you have the choice. For example, in our country, when someone dies, whether they like it or not, the will gets given out according to Islam. But in this country, you can choose to give it out according to Islam or not. Imagine your last action was disobeying Allah, writing a will other than to how Allah Azza wa Jal orders to do so. My dear brothers in Islam, turn back to Allah Azza wa Jal, as He said in the Quran, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And turn back to your Lord in repentance and fall into absolute worship, absolute obedience and utter submission to Him. مِنْ قَبْلِ. There's a condition. Before what, Ya Allah? مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ الْعَذَابِ ثُمَّ لَا تُنْصَرُونَ. Before the punishment befalls you, and then no one will be able to help you. And no one will help you, even Allah won't help you. My dear brothers in Islam, the more we reject our deen, the more parts of our deen that we reject, the more we fall into risk of standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal and having all our actions nullified. Nothing accepted. Turn back to Allah in repentance, like He said. Revise your actions. Revise your Islam. Revise your Iman. Look at what you're doing on a day-to-day basis. And see, am I rejecting any part of our deen? Am I unacknowledging any part of my deen? Because the effect of me rejecting part of my deen is affecting me personally and is affecting the ummah. Because Allah only made that ruling to protect me firstly from the people and to protect the people from me. So every single order of Allah that I refuse to apply, refuse to implement, I'm harming myself and harming my community and then the ummah. Today we have sisters and brothers who when with their deen, their sharia, their Islamic law benefits them, they're the first people at the sheikh's doorstep asking for their rights. As soon as he gives the right to the wife or to her husband, he doesn't like it. He goes to who? To the Aussie courts. Allahu Akbar alaik. Allahu Akbar. You know what Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran? Listen to this verse, my dear brothers. On the page where Allah from ayah 1 to ayah, to the last ayah on that page, He speaks about the munafiqeen, the hypocrites. The lowest of the low. The scummiest of the scum. The people in the lowest hell of hellfire, the hypocrites. From the first ayah to the last ayah on this page, He's talking about them. What's the last verse that He mentions? He says, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal Himself is swearing by Himself. He's making an oath by Himself. The greatest is making an oath by the greatest. O Muhammad, I swear by your Lord. Allah is saying this. They will not believe. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Until when? Three conditions. حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Until they come to you for judgment in each and every single aspect of their lives. Everything they disagree upon, everything they need a judgment for, they come to you, O Muhammad. That's the first. That's not enough, but it's not enough for in our day and age to come to the Quran and Sunnah every single time we have a problem. It's not enough. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Number one. ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُونَ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَدَيْتْ. Part two. And then on top of that, they find absolutely no hesitation in their hearts for that ruling that you gave. That's number two. You have to go to the Quran and Sunnah as a judgment for every single dispute that you have. And on top of that, to be a true Muslim, to be a true submitter of Allah, you have to have no hatred or hesitation towards that ruling that Allah Azza wa Jalla or His Prophet made. That's number two. It's still not enough. It's still not enough. وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. And then against that decision or ruling of Islam, they accept it with absolute and full conviction. Allahu Akbar. What happens today? Even if the guy or the sister does go to the sheikh, when he gives a ruling, let's say he even performs part two and he accepts the ruling. But what does he say? Ah man, he done me. He didn't give me the right hukum. I'm going to do it just because, you know, I don't want anyone to say anything about me. But it wasn't right what he said to me. I'm not happy with it. That's if he does that. Others are going straight to the courts. They're throwing aside the ruling of Allah. And they're going to the courts to take a right which Allah has forbidden upon them. Like that sister who gets divorced and then he gives her mahr. And he gives all her rights, but she still wants to go to court and take her half his wealth. Allahu Akbar. Wallah, that's going to burn you on the Day of Judgment. You've stolen from him. You can do it. I don't mind. I don't worry about the person that's oppressed. Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to give him his right in this world or the next. But that person who does it, do you think he actually succeeded? Wallahi, you're going to burn for that. You've stolen it. And vice versa. The brother who does a business dealing with another brother, and when Islam benefits him, he goes to the sheikh and tells him he took or he did this or the hukum is this. But when the sheikh tells him no it isn't, or the right isn't with you, he wants to go to the courts. My dear brothers, be careful of standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal on the Day of Judgment. And everything you've done was a worship for your desire, not for Allah Azza wa Jal. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers in Islam, there's one more thing I want to mention before I end the talk. I approached a brother in Lebanon while I was studying. And he was doing a few sins, not too major, but there were many of them, many little sins. and they were consistent. So I approached this brother and I told him, brother, what you're doing, 1, 2, 3, it's haram. You know what he told me? He said, I know it's haram, but you know what? I have my limits. I have my boundaries. I don't go, I'm doing a few harams, but that's my limit. I won't do more than that. Allahu Akbar. Do you know better than Allah to make your own deen? To make your own limits and boundaries? To pick and choose what you want from the deen? Allah Azza wa Jalla says it in the Quran, تِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَقْرَبُوهَا. These are the boundaries of Allah. Don't even come close to them. You're completely nullifying them and making your own boundaries. In another verse, تِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَعْتَدُوهَا وَمَنْ يَتَعَدَّ حُدُودَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. These are the boundaries of Allah. Do not ever transgress them. And he who transgressed them, verily they are the oppressors. The oppressors, the same word he used for Fir'aun, Adhalim. How dare you make your own deen? How dare you put your own boundaries other than the boundaries of Allah? What are you going to say to Allah Azza wa Jalla on the day of judgment? You know what gets to me? Those brothers who are quick to perform takfir and tadleel and bid'ah on people. But in reality, when you look at their own life, or their famous statement, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ أَوْ ظَالِمُونَ أَوْ كَافِرُونَ. And they're so quick, as soon as someone does something or that he doesn't like, he's a kafir, he's a dal, he's a fasiq. But when you look at their own lives, they've made their own boundaries for themselves. They've picked and chosen what they want from the deen. They apply part of it and they leave the other part. They're strong in the da'wah, but their manners is filth. Or they're up in the hajjat every single day, but they lie and cheat. Or their abaya is almost up to their knee. But every girl that walks past is, Allahu Akbar. You're quick to kafir and dhalil others, but you don't look at yourself. My dear brothers in Islam, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. Turn back to your Lord in repentance and fall into utter submission and absolute obedience of Allah. That's the only way you're going to be saved on the day of judgment. That's the only way that maybe our actions will be accepted. Be careful of rejecting a part of your deen. Be careful of neglecting a complete portion of your deen. Repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. Turn back to Allah Azza wa Jal. Stop rejecting Allah Azza wa Jal. What do I mean by this? Stop rejecting Allah Azza wa Jal. See, a lady once was sitting, her and her daughter, and someone knocked on the door. So they got up and they answered, and it was the neighbor. The mother got up and answered, and it was the neighbor. The girl remained sitting. As soon as the neighbor came in, assalamu alaikum, the girl just sat there. She was righteous, she was pious, she was of the prayers of the night, but she didn't answer. So the lady thought maybe she didn't hear me. She came closer, assalamu alaikum. She didn't answer. Now her mum's losing her mind. What's wrong with you? Our neighbor, our friend is speaking to you. Fallen on deaf ears, no answer. So she comes close to the lady. She knows she's of the righteous. There's got to be something up. And she puts her hand. Assalamu alaikum. How are you? No answer. The hand is in front of her face. Now she sees it for sure. Still no answer. Ya fulana, what's wrong with you? It's me, your neighbor, your friend, your cousin, Mubarif Ash. Islam tells you to give salam. No one there. Her mother was losing her mind. What's wrong with you? Get up and salam to our neighbor. That's our friend. That's our cousin. You're being disrespectful. What's all that salah and that song for? If you this and you... Fall on deaf ears. No one's answering. Until that lady got upset, she turned around and she walked off saying, by Allah, I will not sit up in a place where I'm not wanted. And she left her to walk to the end of the door while her mum was going crazy and screaming. As soon as she got to the door, she jumps up. And she screams, I'm sorry, my auntie, come back. Forgive me, kaza. She kissed her, she stood up for her, she hugged her, she kissed her hand. Forgive me, kaza. The whole visit that she was there, she was making it up to that lady until she only left there being happy and content and pleased and had forgiven her. But as soon as that lady left, the mother stands up and she loses her mind at the daughter. What's wrong with you? How could you do that? How could you embarrass me like this? Why didn't you get up and salam? You're disrespectful, you're ignorant, you're so on, you're so forth, you pretend you're religious. She was losing her mind. So this girl replies to her, "Oh mother, you're a bigger rejecter than me." She goes, "What do you mean? I got up immediately and I hugged her." She goes, "No, you're a bigger rejecter than me. Think about what you do." "What do you mean? I've never rejected anyone. I've always been nice. I've always been courteous." She goes, "No, you don't reject Bani Adam. You reject Allah Azza wa Jal. Every single night, Allah Azza wa Jal puts out His hand for those who want to repent so He can accept their repentance. And every day Allah Azza wa Jal puts out His hand in the day to accept the repentance of those who want to repent. And every day and night you reject Allah." When was the last time you prayed? When was the last time you fasted? When was the last time you read Quran? When was the last time you applied any of your deen? How long are you going to continue to reject Allah Azza wa Jal? How long are we going to continue to reject Allah Azza wa Jal? Turn back to Allah Azza wa Jal in repentance in every single small and big thing that we do, so that on the Day of Judgment, Allah Azza wa Jal will be pleased with us. He will accept our actions and will give us the highest of paradise.
We are one no mama who should stand with each other through all the highs and lows.